Hi everyone, Harris here with iDownload Blog. So a few months ago we did a series of top apps of the month, and that series took a bit of a hiatus, but we are back now, definitely with top free games of the month. But you can also leave comments down below for any other genres or type of apps that you want to see covered each month. Today we're going to show you three great free apps in the games category for your iOS device. And if you see some hands that aren't mine, those would be my roommates. So let's go ahead and check out these three free games. So the first game is Squish Machine. And the premise is you move around with infinite jumps and side-to-side movements, essentially giving your character the ability to fly in any direction you want. The challenge is to avoid the spikes moving towards the center of the screen from the top and the bottom, making your window of movement continuously smaller. The goal is to maneuver around the obstacles, including other spikes that will implode you and solid objects, in order to land on a platform that will halt and retract the spikes. There are 128 levels to progress through, and trust me, it'll take you some time to complete. The app is certainly family-friendly, as it is reminiscent of an old-school arcade game with fun visuals, upbeat sound designs, and 16 fun characters to unlock. Things we like would be the arcade-like game with the low-D graphics, kind of addicting because there's this huge sense of satisfaction when you land on the platform and you're on the edge of the seat for a lot of the game. It's good for kids, there's no blood or graphic details, and it's not easy, so it's going to be a good challenge. It will pause your music when you go in, but you can resume, and there are plenty of 30-second ads, but you can skip through most of them, so that is the cost of this free game. Up next is Gravitapper. So the premise of this game is an infinite cave runner game with a futuristic backdrop and an equally futuristic soundtrack. This isn't a unique designed game. You've probably seen very similar in different apps, but it's got a nice spin. The objective is to navigate a ball through the peaks and troughs that are presented by the constantly moving track, or the map. As a player, you avoid the walls of the cave. Your score increases by about 200 points per second. However, the obstacles continuously get closer together, making the game more challenging the longer the player lasts. Throughout all of this are motionless glowing spheres called items that the player attempts to contact with their ball to gain an additional 500 points to their score. These spheres only show up every once in a while, so it's best to take advantage of them. Once you do crash, there's an option to see a game-wide leaderboard, which adds a competitive aspect to the game. There's no real way to beat the game, and it is seemingly infinite. Things we like, perfect game to pass the time in between two parts of your schedule or you simply have time on your hands. Again, kid-friendly, no graphic details or vulgarity. There are no ads, which is awesome. Leaderboard gives you scores to beat, and the high score is clearly marked. The third game, Starlet on Wheels Superkart. So basically a Mario Kart riff for your phone. Although this app is not technically a part of Nintendo, the game has a striking resemblance of everyone's favorite childhood pastime. There might be some copyright action eventually, but the goal of this game is relatively simple. Drive your cart to the finish line before anyone else gets there. Along the way, there are puddles, dirt patches, and some sort of animal or beast in the course that should be avoided. If the player happens to hit one of these, then their cart loses much of its momentum. To counterbalance this, there are large stars throughout the course that give the character a temporary boost. An interesting aspect to the game is the fact that there are several different game modes. These include Story Mode, Online Cups, Race Hub, and My Tracks, where you can build a track, which is an interesting component because most apps only have levels that the developers make, but this gives you the option to create one yourself. Lastly, players have the opportunity to upgrade components of their carts to make them faster. The method of payment comes from the reward players collect at the end of each race. Things we like: smooth gameplay, different modes allow for more avenues of entertainment, family friendly, and no ads. Negatives: when I turned off the noise and the music, the noises continue to play regardless. If you have your volume off or muted, then you'll be fine. And there are no mystery boxes like there are in Mario Kart, but if you wanted to get a pretty similar Mario Kart experience, this is it. If you enjoyed any of these app recommendations and test them out, let me know in a comment what you thought of them. If you have any suggestions for apps or categories in the future, leave that down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing, and we will see you in the next video.